Good morning, students. Today we are going to have another lecture of theory of machine, and today's topic which we are going to discuss is internal expanding break. So I have given a rough diagram of how internal expanding break looks. So I have given the diagram. These are the two O1 O2 are the two fulcrum pins, S1 and S2 are the two break shoes, and the shaded portion is the break lining. In between two break shoes, a spring is connected, and in between these two break lining or break shoes, a cam is being provided which ultimately rotates. So let's start with the basics of how it is a what is internal expanding break. So as you all know that as what the name suggested or the what the name signifies, that internal expanding break, so it is a type of break which expands through internally. So through name it suggests this. So I have written a few lines, let's get through it. Internal expanding brakes are used almost exclusively as wheel brakes, but can be found on some cranes. Since it is not in all cases, it can be used in cars, trucks, but it is not a case which is mostly used in commercial purposes. So sometimes in cranes this type of brakes are used. The brake shoes and the brake operating mechanism are supported on a backing plate or brake shield attached to a vehicle axle. So this brake operating mechanism are operated through a black plate and that is attached to the vehicle axle. Simply these are the few lines which we can go through the internal expanding brake. So let us go through the mechanism, how this internal expanding brake works. So now coming to the mechanism part of external expanding brake. So I've already told you that the mechanism shows that through this spring, these two shoes goes outward and inward. It was extract outward when the braking force is required, and then again goes inward when the braking force is no longer required. And this cam varies this force that through since cam is a rotating part, it rotates and it ultimately supplies or it ultimately helps the shoes to go outward and inward. And this spring in between that, it when the force is being applied and the shoes goes outward, through this spring it get back to its original position. One end, these are the two fulcrum points O1 and O2, and through this point it is fixed and it goes outward from the other end. That means these end are fixed points while other end free. So it goes inward and outward through this cross sectional portion, and by this the brake is being applied. So now coming back to the theory portion which I have already written you, this is a mechanism how it works. So the brake shoe of an internal expanding brake is forced outward against the drum, which I have told you that it is forced to outward against the drum to produce the braking action. So the brake shoe is mainly forced outward direction so that the braking action can be applied. One end of the shoe is hinged, and to the braking plate by an anchor pin. I have written you anchor pin, you can write down fulcrum pin. Both anchor and fulcrum pin are the same, while the other end is unattached and can be moved in its support by operating mechanism. So while the other end is free and it is being supported by supporting mechanism, that is by the help of cam and rotating spring, it ultimately moves inward and outward, and by this the braking action is being applied. So when the force from the operating mechanism is applied to the unattached end of the shoe, that means at these portions, so the shoe expands and breaks the wheel. At that point of time, the shoe expands and the braking action is being applied. A retracting spring returns to the shoe to the original position when the braking action is no longer required. This retracting spring, ultimately returns back the shoe to its original position when there is no requirement of braking action. So ultimately, this is a type of brake. If we can justify it in a simpler words, then we can say that internal expanding brake is a type of brake in which two brake shoes are being attached with the braking lining, and a cam is being attached in between these two brake shoes to maintain the, to apply the force and to move help the shoes to move outward and inward. A retracting spring is being attached to come to reach the or to help the suit to come back to its initial position, and two fulcrum pins are given since one end of the spring it should be hinged so that it can rotate through one direction only. So how it works, the suits are being extracted by applying force inward and outward, and by this the braking action is being applied. Here I have left out one portion, that is the braking lining. The braking lining is being given on the brake shoe so that the frictional material, that means there is no absence of friction, and frictional force, as we have already discussed in our previous sections of brakes, that is in band brake and shoe brake, that is the braking force is being applied or being imported through the frictional force. So the brake lining will give you the sufficient amount of force, that frictional force or the coefficient of friction. So for that this braking lining are given. So in short, the shoes goes outward, and through that the brake is being applied, and again the spring help the shoes to come back to its initial position. This is the simple mechanism of internal expanding brake. So write it down, all the mechanism part. I hope you will understand the mechanism. In case if you have any query, then let me know. Thank you.